here Wednesday for a while. I'm going back to Mitchell, and because Thursday and Friday I'll be at Dakota Wesleyan for continuing education. So
it's already running.
Okay. And then so next Sunday will be our Fur Traders Community Worship Service at the Ball Diamonds, and so Scott Barlick will be preaching. And so invite someone to come and worship in case of bad weather. If you don't know what the weather's going to be like, we'll be here at the church. But otherwise, and we'll be having it out there next Sunday at 10 o'clock. There's a thank you in there from Gary and Pat Vanderpaul for the shoebox, Operation Shoebox, that we've given away this fall for this winter. And I believe that's all the announcements I have this morning. Are there any other announcements? And not that let's take a moment to stand and greet each other in the Spirit of Christ.
I got real creative.
You may be seated. We'll start today with the center and chorus, number 63, Blessed Be the Name. We will sing it two times. Today's scripture lesson comes from Luke 12, 13 through 21. Then he put his hands on her, and immediately she straightened up and praised God. Indignant because Jesus had healed on the Sabbath, the synagogue ruler said to the people, "There are 6 days for work. So come." Oh, Luke 12, not 13. Luke 12, 13 through 21. Someone in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, tell my brother to divide the inheritance with me." Jesus replied, "Man, who appointed me a judge or an arbiter between you?" Then he said to them, "Watch out, be on your guard against all kinds of greed. A man's life does not consist in the abundance of his possessions." And he told them this parable. The ground of a certain rich man produced a good crop. He thought to himself, "What shall I do? I have no place to store my crops." Then he said, "This is what I'll do. I'll tear down my barns and build bigger ones. And there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I'll say to myself, 'You have plenty of good things laid up for many years. take life easy, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said to him, you fool, this very night your life will be demanded from you. Then who will get what you have prepared for yourself? This is how it will be with anyone who stores up things for himself, but is not rich towards God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Now if you would please stand for the call to worship. O Lord, open our lips.
And we shall declare your praise.
Please remain standing for the songs of praise, number 2036 in the Faith We Sing, Give Thanks, and also number 620, One Bread, One Body.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, the parent of our Lord Jesus Christ, and our parent, you are to us both mother and father. We, who are your children, draw round your lotus feet to worship you. Your compassion is as the fragrance of the lotus. Though you are enthroned in the heavens, we may draw nigh to you, for your feet stand upon the earth where we humans dwell. We see your compassion in Jesus. Teach us that we belong to you, and that you alone belong to us, and you are enough. Amen. You may be seated. Now, if you would please join me in the act of praise, which is on page 830 and 831, Psalm 107. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, who is good, whose steadfast love endures forever.
Let the Redeemer of the Lord say so, whom the Lord has redeemed from trouble, and gathered in from the lands, from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south.
Some wandered in the desert wastes, finding no way to a city in which to dwell.
Hungry and thirsty, their soul faints within them.
Then, in their trouble, they cried to the Lord, who delivered them from their distress.
And led them by a straight way, till they reached a city in which to dwell.
Let them thank the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wonderful works to humankind.
For the Lord satisfies those who are thirsty, and fills the hungry with good things.
The Lord turns rivers into a desert, springs of water into thirsty ground.
The fruitful land into a salty waste because of its wickedness of its inhabitants.
The Lord turns a desert into pools of water, a parched land into springs of water.
The Lord lets the hungry dwell there, and they establish a city in which to live.
They sow fields and plant vineyards and get a fruitful yield.
But they multiply greatly by the blessing of the Lord, who does not let their cattle decrease.
When they are diminished and brought low through oppression, trouble, and sorrow, the Lord pours contempt upon princes and makes them wander in trackless wastes.
But the Lord raises up the needy out of the affliction and makes their families like flocks.
The upright see it and are glad, and all wickedness stops its mouth.
Whoever is wise, give heed to those things. Consider the steadfast love of the Lord.
I like what the children's come up forward as we sing Jesus Loves Me.
Jesus loves me, this I know. They were going back to the house there, and they were hungry, and all of a sudden, there was two
said, that's what I did, so what are you complaining about?
Yes, by now I know pieces, but anyway, that's what kind of greed is. Greed is, what greed is? Greed is something that you want so bad, and it kind of happens in our house, but that's a true story, that does happen. I will give Sue the little piece and I'll take the big piece, because sometimes I'm greedy, I want that big piece, cake, or whatever it is. Anyway, that reminds me of a story that Noah read to us this morning. Jesus shared a story about a farmer that had a big crop of fields, and he didn't know what to do with it. He said, God blessed me so much, what am I going to do with all this crop? And he said, okay, I know what I'll do. I'll tear down my old barns, and I'll build these big barns, and I'll have this forever. I'll live forever, I will have, money, and be merry, and a lot of food. But then Jesus says, you know what? You're a fool. You know what a fool is, don't you? Yeah, a fool. This kind of guy was with the food. Jesus said, or in the parable, Jesus said, you rich fool, you're going to die tonight. And who's going to get all this stuff? See, the rich man was treasuring everything for himself. He wasn't going to share it with nobody. And so that's the point of our story for today. God has blessed us so much stuff. But the question is, will we are willing to share that with somebody? You know, that's why we come to the church and give our offering to people in need and stuff. That's why God gave us all this stuff. It all belongs to God. And, God wants us to help other people. So remember that when you want the last piece of cake or whatever, or maybe Daddy wants that last piece of cake or whatever, you gotta share, okay? All right, let's pray. And you can pray with me. The congregation can repeat after me. Let's pray. Dear God, you have blessed us with so much that we need. Help us to be generous and to share with those who may not have. Let us join together in our hymn of prayer, number 500, or on the screen, Spirit of God, descend upon my heart.
Amen.
confess our sins to God and one another. Please join me now in a prayer confession. Let us pray. Our merciful, tender God, you gave birth to your world, conceiving and bearing all that lives and breathes. We come to you as your daughters and sons, aware of our aggression and anger, and drive our dominion and manipulate others. We ask you to forgive us, and by the gentle touch of your Spirit, help us to find a renewed sense of compassion, that we may truly live as your people in service to all. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. May these words be our words of assurance and pardon for us today. Amen. As we come also to our time of prayer, are there joys or concerns we'd like to lift up this morning? We do like to lift Richard up in our prayers as well. And yeah, we do like to talk with Michelle.
I have a note just to add to that. This week, tomorrow, he goes to the vascular doctor to see if they can put a stent in that leg for some immediate relief. And then he gets his port in on Tuesday and first chemo treatment on Tuesday. Okay. He'll be up in the hospital Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. They say 3 days and then home for 3 weeks.
So anyway, Richard will be having that all in Sioux Falls. You don't have to go to Rochester, so Sioux Falls is a little closer. So thank God you don't have to travel all the way over there and go from there. So please keep Richard in your prayers. Also, Gary Rada, leave have him in your prayers as well. And so anyway, are there any other joys or concerns you want to lift up?
I'd just like your prayers, not this coming Monday, but the next Monday, I'm going to have an angiogram. When I got really sick in May, my heart did some funky things, and
okay.
Okay,
so keep Janice in prayers. Not this Monday, but the following Monday, she'll have her angiogram on. As well, so, okay. Yes. Again, our area farmers, we want to lift all those people up, and those are going through a difficult time, whether it's farming, weather issue, health issues, family, whatever, lift all these people up in your prayers, all right? Okay.
Pastor, also, these killings that they're having.
Yes.
One in Walmart and one in bar last night.
Yeah, we're going to keep all these people that shopping and men bars, whatever. So it's people that lost loved ones or that really hurt and stuff. So yeah, that's tough. All right. I know you guys are good prayer warriors, so all right. Okay. Let's go back to prayer. Holy God, you have held us in your arms and taught us to walk. And when we turn away from you, your anger stops us like a lion's roar. Yet you cannot give us up, for we are your children. We are your children of warm and tender compassion. And remind us of the healing that comes from your forgiveness. And teach us to use our energies for the common good. Forgive us for failing to question why some define their lives by the abundance of possessions, while others struggle to find what is needed to survive that day. We thank you for the joy that comes not from full storehouses, but from having Jesus as our friend. We thank you for the peace of mind that comes from being rich toward God. Strengthen our resolve to give up whatever in us fails to reflect your glory, and to teach us to set our minds on your grace. Renew us in the image of our Creator, that we may share with you a likeness that transcends race and class. Our life, O God, is a gift from you. Keep it safe with Christ, so that when God is revealed, we will be revealed to him in glory. And gracious God, we lift up the joys and concerns that are shared here as well on our hearts this morning. And God, we want to lift up those, especially in our prayer concern list this week. We want to lift up Harriet Adele, Bertha Cardinal, Don Lucas, Linda Murphy, Little Rich Greger, Gary Rada, Sally Tuchek's brother Dale, and then Farley's brother Lauren, who had surgery. Lord, lift up all the concerns that were shared here as well in our hearts. And we'd like to take a moment and talk to you, God, in silence. And whatever's on our hearts, we'd like to talk to you about. Lord, we lift up our area farmers and those that are going through a rough time. We be with those that are struggling financially. Be with those that have some kind of illness that controls their lives. And Lord, we lift up all those that were killed or hurt during these last few days of shootings. Again, Lord, just comfort these loved ones. Comfort us as well. And Lord, we also lift up our Dakota Conference prayer list and lift up our bishop and our district superintendents and lift up the churches of Oaks, Park River Federal, Tulare United, Watertown Cornerstone, Watertown First. Lord, we lift this all up in your name, we pray. Amen. Now may the words of my mouth and meditation of all of our hearts now be acceptable in your sight, O Lord. Amen. An old radio program on the radio had a sketch of Jack Benny being robbed at gunpoint. Now, some of you probably don't know Jack Benny, but Jack Benny was the tightest man that ever lived. So one time, a robber went up behind him and asked him, "Hey, Jack, you know, your money or your life?" He got no response. He asked again, the robber said, "Hey, buddy, your life or your money?" To which Jack responded was, "Give me a moment, I'm thinking about it." We laugh about that, don't we? But Jesus' parable makes us stop to think it over. The materialism of this era is well known. And many people live to collect more and more and more. But is it worthwhile? The parable of the rich rich fool makes us to take a moment to reflect on the culture of collecting items. Now, why did the farmer think he had to use his large crops just for him? Well, selfish becomes a habit. Sometimes people don't think about things like they should. There's a story about a Roman king who came upon a soldier standing at attention in a corner of a palace garden. "What are you guarding?" the king said. "I don't know," the soldier said. "The captain ordered me here." So the king went to the captain. And the captain says, "Well, written regulation detailing that a guard to be signed in this area." But the king wanted to find out more about that. So he did some research and he found out years before Catherine the Great planted a rose bush in that corner and she ordered someone to protect it for the day. Now 100 years later, the soldier is still standing in that barren spot. Let's not let our possession own us or even thinking about it. So why did Jesus talk about this parable? You see, this man asked him to have his brother divide his inheritance with him. And Jesus said, "Why should I be the judge to do that?" Now, I don't know if the brother was wealthy or what, but Jesus warned, he said, "Watch out. Be on your guard against all kinds of greed." And then Jesus tells him that parable. The rich farmer, of course, was blessed with a big crop. And he said to himself, "Well, what should I do? I have no place to store all of these crops." Then he said, "Okay, I'll tear down my old barns and I'll build these big barns. And I'll store all this up for myself. And I'll say to myself, now you can relax, you can eat, and you can be merry for many years." The farmer, you see, wanted everything for himself. And that's why God was very upset with him. You see, we can be very selfish when we think about ourselves. Thinking about oneself rather than helping others. And that's why God tells this parable, and then he says that farmer's a fool. He says, this very night you are going to die. Who's going to get all this stuff? That kind of makes you think a little bit. We're not sure if the farmer had a family or not. But all the things you have prepared for, whose will they be? So it is with those who store up treasures for themselves, but not toward rich toward God. You see, the possessive spirit of that farmer ruined him. And you see, it can ruin us as well. ABC had a news presentation on special on greed one time, and reporter John Stossel was doing the reporting. And the program began to look at the Biltmore Estates in North Carolina. Can you put that up, Darcy? I want to have you see what this mansion looked like. See, this mansion here is in North Carolina, Biltmore Estate, I think is what it's called. Anyway, this was built just for one man to live in that. Imagine living that all by yourself. In there, it had 255 rooms. The dining room was as high as a 5-story building. The dining table seats 64. So the reporter asked him, "You, since you're this rich, you must make friends pretty easy." But here, you can take in the, if you see the inside of that, I hope you go home and Google that and see what the inside of that really looks like. But, you know, it costs $1 million of the stuff that he has inside of there. And John Stossel says, "It's beautiful, but isn't this greedy? Who needs $100 million house?" But we give, giving spirit can be our liberation. For example, there was a story about a man who spoke to the Lord about heaven and hell. And the Lord said, I'm going to show you what heaven and hell is like. So he took him to the one room. And one of the rooms, there was a lot of people there. There's a big pot of stew there. And big, big, long spoons. But they were very, they were just malnourished. They were very greedy. And the suffering there was terrible. Now the Lord said, man, come follow me. I want to show you what heaven's like. So he took this man into another room. And there it was a big pot in the middle of the room, a whole bunch of people there, and they had the same long spoons. But yet in heaven, they were nourishable. They're happy. And the man said, I don't understand. Both rooms are identical. How come heaven's so happy and heaven or hell is so miserable? And everything's identical. The Lord smiled and said, aha, here in heaven, they had to learn to feed each other. You see, in hell, they were trying to feed themselves with those long spoons and they couldn't do it. But in heaven, you had to feed other people. That's the difference between heaven and hell. So the old question is still very real. Is it your money or is it your life? Which will you choose? Let's pray. Most loving and just God, you called us to move beyond the values of the world and to store our treasures in you and eternity. Give us the courage to believe and to follow you, Lord. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Our hymn of invitation is number, should be on the screen or in your hymnal, I Come With Joy, number 617. Would you stand, are you able, please? Suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried.
The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From then he should come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image. You breathed into us the breath of life. And when we turn away our love failed, your love remains steadfast. You delivered us from captivity and made a covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets, who looked for the day when justice shall roll down like the waters, and righteousness like the ever-flowing stream, when nations shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn of war anymore. And so now, with your people on earth and the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed him to preach the good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people, heal the sick, feed the hungry, and eat with sinners. And by the baptism of his suffering and his death and his resurrection, you gave birth to your church. To deliver us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by the water and the Spirit. In his accession, you exalted him to sit and reign with you at your right hand. On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, he blessed it, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat, for this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And likewise, Jesus then took the cup, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you, for this is the cup of the new covenant poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. When you drink this, remember me." And so in your mighty acts of Jesus Christ, we now offer ourselves our praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us, as we now proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. Pour now your Holy Spirit upon us gathered here on these gifts of bread and wine. May they be for us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood.
And by your Spirit, make us one with Christ and one with each other and one in the ministry to all the world until Christ comes in that final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, our honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Let us join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and power, and glory forever. Amen. Of course, in United Methodist Church, we have an open table. Everyone is welcome to come and accept that. I'm going to ask Susan and Michelle to come forward, please. I'll serve them first, and they'll serve me. And then we will invite you to come down. And when you do come down, make sure you bring your offering forward, too. So. The table was set, the ushers of the scourge have come down this way, and if you'd like to kneel afterwards, you're welcome to do that, or if you'd like to go back, please go back this way. So, the table was set, the ushers of the scourge out. Thank you.
Let us pray.
Eternal God, we just give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may now go into the world in the strength of your Spirit, to give ourselves for others in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Would you please stand for our benediction, please? Following our worship service, fellowship downstairs, if I took it down for that. Go forth now in peace, and may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And all of God's people said, Amen. We'll sing God Bless America for our closing response.